In this lecture, we are going to study class C, that is complementary commutation of thyristors. The circuit of class C commutation looks like this. This is the class C type of commutation circuit, which has got resistors R1 and R2, capacitor C. There is thyristor T1 here and thyristor T2 here. Now, what we have to study here is we have to understand how thyristor is turned off. Okay, so let us understand the working of the circuit. This is the same circuit I have taken here. Thyristor T1 and thyristor T2, both of them are in off state. Now in this circuit, thyristor T1 here, see here, thyristor T1 is turned on, whereas thyristor T2 is turned off. Because thyristor T1 is turned on, it is represented by a short circuit here. Okay. Now, when the supply voltage is given, current will start flowing. Here, the main current starts flowing. At this point, it gets splitted up and flows through resistance R1, and some part flows through resistance R2. The part of current that flows through resistance R2, that same current is flowing through the capacitor, thereby charging the capacitor. And the total current that flows through our thyristor T1 is this current and this current added up together. So the current flowing through thyristor T1 is IT1 is equal to, IT1 is the current flowing through thyristor T1, IR1, that is this current flowing through R1, and IR2, that is this current flowing through resistor R2. Now, this current which is flowing through resistor R2 is the same current which is flowing through the capacitor. So, IR2 can be replaced by IC. So, total current flowing through thyristor T1 is IT1 is equal to IR1 plus IC. Okay. Now this thyristor T2 is off. Because it is off, it is as good as it is open circuited. So here these two terminals will represent that open circuit. Now whatever is the voltage that capacitor has got charged to, that same voltage will appear across this open circuit or across this thyristor T2. Now as this current is flowing through capacitor C, it will charge the capacitor, and as the capacitor gets charged, this plate will become positive and this plate will become negative. Now if we want to turn this thyristor T1 off, we will have to turn on thyristor T2 on. Okay. So in this circuit, it is shown that thyristor T2 is also turned on by applying a proper gate triggering pulse at its gate terminal. So once thyristor T2 is turned on, the negative plate, this negative plate of capacitor C appears at anode of T1, and positive plate appears at cathode of T1. And we know that when anode receives negative terminal and cathode becomes positive, it means that a reverse voltage appears across T1 and T1 turns off. So this is how T1 turns off, which is represented here in this circuit as open circuit. So in order to turn off T1, we have to turn on T2. Now how will be the current? This is the main current in this circuit. This is T1 off and T2 on. So this is the main current which gets splitted up here into some part flows through R1. That same current flows through capacitor C, thereby charging it, and some part flows through R2. And the total current flowing through T2 is IT2, which is equal to IR1, which is same as IC, plus IR2. So that will be the current flowing through thyristor T2. Now if we want to turn off this thyristor T2, we will have to turn on T1. What will happen when we turn on T1? Here, as the capacitor gets charged again, this plate will become positive now and this plate will become negative. That is, ulta of this thing will happen. Ulta of this polarity will appear here. So as negative plate appears across anode of T2 and positive plate through this shorted T1 appears across the cathode of T2, T2 will get turned off. Okay. So if we have to turn on T2, if we have to turn off T2, we have to turn on T1. And here, if we have to turn off T1, we have to turn on T2. So that is why this type of commutation circuit is called as a complementary commutation circuit. Okay, now this is as far as working of the circuit is concerned. Now let us understand how will be the waveforms looking like. So in this next slide, let us see how the waveforms look like. This is the same circuit I have taken here, where T1 is turned on, the first case where T1 is turned on and T2 is off. Okay, so these are the waveforms. This is the first waveform, which is IG1. IG1 meaning the gate trigger pulse, which is applied to the gate of T1 to turn it on. So IG1 with respect to time T. Second is IG2 waveform, which is gate trigger pulse applied at the gate of T2 to turn it on with respect to time T. Then we have IT1, that is the current flowing through thyristor T1 with respect to time T. Then we have voltage across thyristor T1. Then voltage across thyristor T2, VT2. Then voltage across the capacitor, VC. Then we have IT2, that is current flowing through thyristor T2. And last we have current through capacitor, which is nothing but the charging current. Okay. You can take these waveforms in any order that you want. We will understand now, as things go on in this circuit, how the waveforms will look like. For proper understanding, we have also done the marking here. The intervals are marked properly. So first what we have done, T1 is turned on by applying a proper gate trigger pulse at its gate terminal. These are the markings taken. So at this marking, T1 is turned on. At this marking, T2 will be turned on. At this marking again, T1 will be turned on. Okay, so those are the markings taken. So first, IG1 is given at the gate of T1 and T1 is turned on. Once T1 turns on, this current flows, okay, and this current flows here, and the total current that flows through T1 is this current, which is shown in green color. Now, as this current, which is flowing through resistance R2, is the same current that is charging capacitor C, so that is the charging current of capacitor C, which you can see here. This is the charging current of capacitor C. So, as the capacitor gets charged, and as it gets fully charged, once the capacitor is fully charged meaning the voltage across capacitor will be this voltage, that is supply voltage Vs. So once the capacitor has got fully charged, that is shown here, as the capacitor gets fully charged, the current flowing through capacitor TK is down to zero. So here, once the capacitor is fully charged, at this point, the current TK is down to zero. Now here, for this period, that is, we have marked it for this interval. This is the period where capacitor is getting charged, current is flowing through the capacitor. Now, during that time, current through thyristor T1, that is IT1, is equal to IR1 plus IR2, which is nothing but IT1 is equal to IR1 plus IC. So, this is the current, you can see here in green color, this is the current flowing through thyristor T1, which is shown here by green arrow. The same current is shown here by this green waveform. Now, once the capacitor current decays down to zero, it means that this component is not there in IT1. So now IT1 only consists of one component of current, that is IR1. So this current only consists of current through IR1. This current is not there because that current has decayed down to zero. IC has become zero. So IT1 is equal to IR1. So this value is shown here. This is IR1 only. So this value, this sloping waveform, this is IR1 plus IC, and at this point, you can see here, at this point IC decays down to zero. So that is why IT1 is equal to only IR1. Now as thyristor T1 is on, let's see what is the waveform across its voltage waveform. Voltage waveform will be zero because it is turned on. Turned on meaning it is as good as shorted. So that is why voltage across a short is always negligible value of voltage, which is zero taken here. This is off. T2 is turned off. So what will be the voltage across T2? And let us see what is the voltage across capacitor. See here, voltage across capacitor will be from zero, capacitor starts to charge. With this current, capacitor starts to charge. With this plate getting positively charged, this plate getting negatively charged. So as the capacitor charges from zero, it rises up, it gets charged, to full voltage Vs. So this is the voltage Vs to which capacitor gets charged. And once it gets charged, it remains there because as the current, charging current decays down to zero, voltage across capacitor remains constant to Vc, remains constant to Vs. This is the Vs voltage. And whatever is the voltage appearing across capacitor C, that same voltage is appearing across thyristor T2. So as this capacitor voltage is increasing, that same increasing voltage will appear across T2, and as the capacitor voltage is remaining constant at Vs, that same voltage will appear across T2. So whatever is the voltage across Vc, across capacitor, that same voltage appears across T2 because T2 is open circuited here. So this voltage directly comes across T2. Now, if we have to, so this is one part. This interval, this is one part. Now let's see the second part wherein we have to turn off T1. So now if we want to turn off thyristor T1, we will have to turn on T2. So at this time interval, a gate trigger pulse is given for gate terminal of T2 and T2 is turned on. So at this interval, at this instant of time, T2 is turned on. Once T2 is turned on, let's see what happens. This is the voltage Vs which the capacitor has charged to. So this is Vs. Now as this is turned on, see here, negative terminal is appearing across anode and appearing at the anode, and positive terminal is appearing across cathode. So whatever is this voltage which is the capacitor having, whatever is the capacitor voltage, what is the capacitor voltage? Capacitor voltage is Vs. So this capacitor voltage will appear in reverse polarity across T1. Why reverse polarity? Because anode is getting negative, cathode is getting positive. So that is why reverse voltage appears across T1. That is shown here. See, this is minus Vs appearing here. This is minus Vs appearing. Vair asta to plus Vs, sakal asta to minus Vs. So this is minus Vs appearing across T1, which turns T1 off. So once we turn on T2, the voltage across capacitor applies a reverse voltage across the thyristor T1, where it makes anode negative, cathode positive, and thus because of that reverse voltage, thyristor T1 turns off. So this is the instant where T2 is turned on, and at the same instant T1 is turned off. Okay. Now, once T1 is turned off and T2 is turned on, because T2 is turned on, voltage across it will be zero because it is shorted now. Current through T1 is off, so current cannot flow through it. So current through T1 will be zero. Next we have current through T2. Earlier it was zero because it was open earlier. Now at this instant it is turned on. So now current through T2 will be current flowing through R1 and C plus current flowing through resistor. So this higher value of voltage as T1 was having here, this value, that same value will come here. Okay. So here this is IT2, which is equal to IR1 plus IR2. Now the capacitor, here the capacitor has got charged fully with this plate positive, this plate negative. Now once T2 is turned on, capacitor will start to discharge. As you can see this line, I'll show one more time. As you can see this line, see here capacitor gets discharged, attains zero. Now as the capacitor voltage is falling from Vs, from plus Vs, it is falling to zero. So this voltage across thyristor T1 will start increasing from minus Vs to zero. See, whatever is the voltage across capacitor, that same voltage comes across thyristor T1 in reverse polarity. Okay, so this voltage across capacitor is changing from plus Vs to zero. It is discharging, whereas voltage across T1 is changing from minus Vs to zero. Hangasar zata te ulta hanga zata. Okay. Now as this is reaching zero, this is also reaching zero. Hangasar to discharge zalo, hangasar zero zalo, ata kine zatle, ata to purat charge zatlo. So capacitor recharges now. Recharges. And when it is fully charged, it has a value of minus Vs. वयर आसा तो प्लस वी एस आनी सकयल आसा तो हो मायनस वी एस वीच आय हॅव नॉट मार्क हियर जस्ट टेक इट एज मायनस वी एस सो कॅपेसिटर नाव अगेन चार्जीस टू मायनस वी एस सो हांगासर कितें जातलें हो झिरो टू प्लस वी एस वयतलो कित्याक की हो हांगा झिरो टू मायनस वी एस वयता सो हो हांगा झिरो टू प्लस वी एस वयतलो एंड वन्स इफ चार्जीस फुल्ली हियर करंट वील डीके डावन टू झिरो यू कॅन सी द करंट हियर This is discharging and charging of the capacitor. Once it gets fully charged, once it gets fully charged here to minus Vs, current gets decayed down to zero and it is attaining zero value. Whereas this voltage across capacitor will remain constant at minus Vs. Whereas this voltage across thyristor will remain constant as plus Vs. Hangasar jha jata hain, ulta hanga jata. Okay? And current flowing through our T2 on asa, okay? Whether current aslo to IR1 plus IR2. Pun hangasar kin zala? Hangasar IC0 zala. So IC matlarus IR1. So IC asa to 0 zala. Teka lagun hangasar ekuch component aslo. So the current flowing through T2 will be only one component. That is this component, not this component. Current through capacitor has become zero here. See here, it has become zero. So, was a current asa? The factor current through R2, that is IR2. Okay, so this is the second part where we have seen what happens when T2 is turned on and what happens when T1 is turned off. Okay, and then so this is IT2 is equal to IR2, that is the equation. And then we again have whatever had happened in this interval, this time interval where T1 was turned on. Again we have here T1 turned on. Why is T1 turned on again here? To turn off this T2. Pahili hanga T1 on aslo, T2 off aslo. Hanga sir T2 on kelo so as to turn off T1. Ata hanga sir T1 off asa, T2 on asa. So T2 hanga sir jo on asa to off karpak lagun. Purat hanga T1 on karo. T2 is on right now, so we have to turn on T1 so as to turn off T2. T2 off karpak, T1 on karo. Okay, so T1 on karpak lagun IG1 divap. IG1 is the gate pulse given at its gate terminal. Once IG1 is given, thyristor T1 will turn on. Thyristor T1 on jatugu, hangasar jo current aslo, toch porat hangatlo. This higher value of current is the current flowing through IR1 plus IR2 ani magir. कॅपेसिटरांतलो करंट डीके जाता टू झिरो बिकॉज कॅपेसिटर गॅट्स फुल्ली चार्ज ताका लागून हांगासर एकूच कंपोनंट उरता सो हियर द कॅपेसिटर सो हियर एट दीस इंस्टंट वॅन T1 इज टर्न्ड ऑन युअर VT2 वील रिसीव मायनस VS दॅट इज दीस वोल्टेज हांगासर सेकंड टायमार ही प्लेट आसा ती पॉझिटीव जातली ही नेगेटीव जातली सो नेगेटीव हांगा येतली एनोडा कडेन पॉझिटीव आसा ती थ्रू T1 हांगा येतली कॅथोडा कडेन सो हो ऑफ जातलो आनी T2 कडेन दॅट इज हाव T2 कडेन मायनस वोल्टेज येतली मायनस ऑफ VS सो T2 कडेन हांगा मायनस VS जाता सी हियर दीस इज मायनस VS सकयल आसा ती मायनस VS सो दीस इज मायनस VS सो कॅपेसिटर नाव गॅट्स डिस्चार्ज अटेन्स झिरो सो हांगाय कितें जातलें वोल्टेज गोज टू झिरो मागीर कॅपेसिटर अगेन चार्जीस टू प्लस VS सो दीस वोल्टेज वील ऑल्सो रायज टू प्लस VS एन्ड दीस वोल्टेज वील रिमेन कॉन्स्टंट हियर बिकॉज करंट थ्रू द कॅपेसिटर इज decaying to zero, so this voltage will also remain constant at Vs. VT1 asa to on kela, so that is why voltage across VT1 is zero. IT2, that is current through thyristor T2 is zero, kidak ki to off kela ata. And this is the same capacitor current. Hanga discharge ani charging of capacitor zata, ani hanga sir fully charge zatugu, current through capacitor zero zata, taka lagun was zero current. This is the working of class C commutation circuit. Okay? Thank you.